Education for the individual is hope. Hope that he can achieve his goals. Hope that he can become a contributing citizen. Hope, what all of us hope, that we are better than the worst thing we've ever done in our lives.
Originally, education wasn't a part of my reentry program. I didn't see myself going to school once I did return back to the society. But once I did get into the program, I realized that education was actually the path to my reentry.
It is my privilege to welcome you to our facility as we celebrate the success of the John Jay Prison to College Pipeline.
This program and the stuff we're now doing at the state is very important in changing the conversation and changing the narrative.
We administer credit-bearing liberal arts courses to men who are incarcerated here at Otisville.
It's not even about second chances, it's about first chances. Most of the individuals in our program never were able to access education.
I almost lost my life. I was 16 years old when I got incarcerated. I'm 26 now.
I had been out of school for many years, so it was really difficult for me here.
Trying to find myself, like, was I a felon or was I a student, right?
The program here prepared me for the workload, the intensity of doing the classwork.
It took a few semesters for me to be like, all right, that's not part of my life, that's not who I am. I'm actually like everyone else here, I'm a student.
It's difficult when I see guys that I was just here with last year. I wasn't gonna come at first, because I was thinking about it. And I was like, you know what? I have to come because it's bigger than me. I'm not here to hide my story. I'm here to better people.
93% of all prisoners are eventually released. In my mind, it's just logical that we invest in these people because, you know, prison reform is community reform.
This is so powerful to me, to be able to see upfront and personal the things that we talked about. From a policy perspective, it is so important that you're getting this personal experience because you can't develop policy without understanding its real impact on real people.
There's so much that can be done through education, and a lot of inmates, even if they're serving long sentences, really need that hope for a future. And it's because of education and program like this program that John Jay runs that keeps hope alive.
You know, my transformation started many years ago while incarcerated, because for a lot of us, you know, we have to start here. You have to be prepared way ahead of time, and it starts here.